So you want to trademark your brand, huh? Well, you've come to the right place. I'm Pankaj Raval, trademark attorney. I'm here today to talk a little bit about how to search for a trademark yourself. This is a DIY tutorial on where to go and what to do to search for your trademark to see if there's any conflicts out there. Hope this helps. Let's get into it. Hey, I'm Pankaj Raval, founder of Carbon Law Group. And today I'm talking about searching for a trademark. You're probably here because you're looking to get a trademark, but you're not sure where to start. The first thing you want to do is make sure you do a search on the USPTO. That is where the trademark register is located. It's called the United States Patent and Trademark Office, USPTO.gov. You're going to go there and you're going to click on trademarks. When you go to trademarks, you're going to say search for trademark. When you get to search for trademark, now you're going to have three options. You're going to have a basic search, search for design mark or word mark, and then a freeform search. Freeform search is really for power users, so I wouldn't worry about that right now. Let's focus on the basic search. So once you click on the basic search, you're going to be given an option to enter in the search term. It's pretty straightforward. Whatever your trademark is, let's say it is Pepsi. Okay, you're going to enter in Pepsi, and lo and behold, there's a few Pepsis out there. It's going to tell you of all the potential conflicts, and also you're going to see numbers to the right, which gives you the classes. There are 45 different classes in which someone can register a trademark. This is really important because a class for cosmetics, for example, could be class 3, but a class for consulting services might be class 41 or 45. So it really depends on what you're doing, and that'll determine the class you're in. So this is really important because if someone has a mark in, let's say, class 3, but you're trying to do automotive repair work, and that's a totally different class, you could be okay. As long as that other mark is not a famous mark, and a famous mark is kind of subject to a lot of interpretation, but if you've heard of the name, if it's well known around the country, it's most likely considered famous, and you want to steer clear of those, even if they're not in your same class. So the assumption is, let's say your mark is not interfering with a very well-known brand, and you want to register in a certain category. Once you search on the USPTO, you're going to see what's out there and what the potential conflicts are. If you don't see any conflicts, that's great news, but that's not the end of it. Okay, you want to make sure you also search for marks that may be similar. In trademark law, the first term carries the greatest meaning. This is really important. When it comes to arguing infringement claims and also protecting our clients' marks, it's really important to clarify that the first term carries the greatest commercial impression when it comes to talking to judges and looking at the case law. So if you have a mark that's several words, and let's say you share the first word with another mark, that could be a problem. Even though the marks are not identical, if you guys share the same first term and you guys are in similar enough classes, then you may have a problem. And again, when it comes to classes, it's not always exact overlap. Even if it's a different class, if you guys are doing something similar, if the trade channels are similar, then you could run into problems. But let's say everything turns out well, you don't see any conflicts on the USPTO website. Next thing you want to do is make sure you do a Google search. Are there any other people using the name that maybe haven't registered for a trademark? Because even if you haven't registered for a trademark, yet you've used the name in commerce, you still have rights, and that person could still cancel you even if they didn't register a trademark. So it's really important to know that you want to be not only the first user, but you also want to be the first register of a trademark. That means on the USPTO. Use is very important in the United States. If that's all looks good, there's nothing on Google, USPTO looks good, you want to go and search social media. Search all the major social media networks and try to lock in your brand. If someone has your same handle on a certain social media, just look into that a little bit. Could it be conflicting? Because at the end of the day, trademark law is about consumer confusion. If you are causing consumer confusion, or if there's a possibility you could cause consumer confusion, then you could have an issue with your mark. So it's really important to do a proper search. There's a lot of great services out there that will also do searches. There's third-party searches. We pay a lot of money for a database, and we do comprehensive searches for our clients all the time. We can do clearance searches, as well as we do what's called a much more in-depth search, where we look at the likelihood of confusion. We weigh the 13 factors that courts will consider when evaluating whether a mark is confusingly similar, and we'll provide clients with a really detailed report just to know what they're getting into. If it's an expensive brand, if you're going to be spending a lot of money and investing in this brand, what we highly recommend doing a proper search, an extensive search, because you could be in a position where you put in a lot of money and then find out about 6-8 months later that you might have to change that name because someone has something similar out there. So these are some of the things to consider. This is not an exhaustive list. Again, this is for informational purposes only. We'd love to help you with your trademark registration needs. We have basic packages, we have professional packages, and we have premium packages. We also offer office action insurance. If you file your trademark and then you get an office action, we actually have some insurance for that to help people offset some of the costs that they could be facing. My name is Pankaj Raval, founder of Carbon Law Group. Hopefully this is helpful, and I can't wait to hear from you. Thank you.